Guys, and welcome to my channel. I'm back at it again, and I'm so thankful to the Lord. Today's message, or motivation rather, as I'd like to call it, is titled The Real Life. Why have I titled this message that way? Is the fact that I've observed that, you know what, this is sort of a brief summary that most people who are walking with Christ or beginning to walk with Christ, like passionately, but it'll probably use something like this, you know, unless of God, guys, can reveal something else to you. This is not entirely strictly I'm saying follow, but I'm just saying that this could be one of the things that could help. Okay, fine. What is this real life? This real life, guys, as I'm opening my message, basically means that there are these few principles which I've seen to work exactly for me, at least. And those principles are confession. Based on confession, on the word of God, the way of life, meaning the way that you live, prayer, your prayer, and then waiting on the Lord with patience. So what is this confession? So basically, this is targeted towards everyone. Anyone who has probably been living in the world or doing whatever, or just not having a genuine relationship with the Lord. So obviously you would want to come back, confess your sins in terms of Romans, acknowledge Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and then you take the way from there and start walking with Him. So my scripture for this confession is based on 1 John 1 verse 9. It reads and says, "If we confess our sin, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness." So basically the scripture does say that for as long as we confess our sins, He will forgive us because He is a loving God, which I translated to that. Other scriptures that you might want to check on confessions will be your Psalms 32 verse 5, Nehemiah 9 verse 2, and Leviticus 26 verse 40. So guys, I hope you have really understood what confession is. Moving on to the second one. Oh no, before I move on to the second one, there's another interesting verse in Romans 8 verse 1. That still talks about what happens after confession. It says that there is therefore now condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. So once you have confessed your sins, you're not condemned. You are forgiven. God has forgiven them. He says that I have forgiven all those sins. I have thrown them far, far away to the depths of the sea, something like that. And if the enemy comes and he starts saying, "Oh, you did this, there's the scripture you can point to him and says, "I am forgiven because I've confessed my sins." And the Lord says that I am indeed forgiven, you know. And then moving on to the second one, which is the word. The word is the word of God. Let me read for you from Joshua 1 verse 8. It says, "This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night. And you may ask that you may observe to do according to that which is written therein. For then shall you have good success." So the book of the law, what is the book of the law? The book of law is the Bible. Like I said, it's the word. So the Bible, we are told in Joshua that we should read the Bible all the time. Let us read the Bible all the time. Let us ask the Holy Spirit to teach us how to read the Bible. You know, sometimes people would be like, "But how do I read the Bible?" You know, like I remember it used to be for me, like, "How do I read the Bible?" But then you just start off by starting to read. Like sometimes you just say, "God, I'm holding your word here. Speak to me." You know, He will direct and He will really speak to you. He does speak through that word because the word of God is life. And also, we move on to the third one, which is your way of life. I've posted the series, my last series that I posted was on You Are the Light. And with you, within the video of You Are the Light, I talk about different sins and how to live within sin. I mean, live being tempted, but then not living in sin, you know. So the way of life in this, I think, also touches on that video that I have already posted. I'll put a link on my description box that if you want to watch it, then you can go and watch it. So my scripture for the way of life is derived from 1 Joshua. Again, it's still within 1 Joshua, just like the word that I'm reading, the last part, which says that thou may observe to do according to all that which is written therein. For then shall you have good success. So if we are living according to what is written within the scripture, also being away from sin, yes, being tempted, but then not living in sin. The Lord in His word says, then we shall have success. It is guaranteed that we shall have success. God does answer prayer, guys. Yes, He does answer prayers. It's just that there are different components that you have to learn. Like what would have happened if my prayer is not answered? And like I said to you, all of these things, you can get to know them only if you're working in God and walking with Him and Him teaching you that this is what I want for you, this is what I don't want for you, so that you can be able to get your breakthroughs, so that you can be able to know, no, this is the time for me to wait, so that you can know what exactly to do, because he will be speaking to you. And guys, as I'm saying that He'll be speaking to you, God speaks to everyone. Never ever listen to somebody telling you that, oh no, God doesn't speak to you. God speaks to everyone, even the people who would be in the depths of sin. God speaks to all of us because He loves us, you know. So, and for as long as you do that, God indeed will make you a success. And then the other one is the prayer. Prayer is, if you are living in a Christian life, you need prayer every day. Prayer is water, guys. Prayer is also what is life. It's life for the spirit. You know, as much as the word of God is feeds the spirit, you need to pray. Guys, pray, 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 pray. Even when you don't feel like, pray. And the scripture for prayer is derived from the book of Philippians 4, verse 6, and it restarts, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving let your requests be made unto God. You see, he's saying don't be anxious for anything, don't even worry about anything. Whatever you want, put it in prayer to the Lord. Put it in prayer to the Lord. And then there's another scripture which I like so much, and let me read that scripture, because you say it is 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 17. It just simply says, pray without ceasing. Pray without ceasing. Like, this is the ish, guys. I used to think that, you know, prayer has to be limited for a certain thing. Like, I would probably say, I have to pray for a week and then God has heard me. Guys, maybe for some, they will feel like they have to pray. But for me, I feel like pray. Pray until you see something happening. Don't stop praying. Pray until you get an answer. And you know how you've gotten an answer? Would be the manifestation of whatever you would have been asking for. For, you know, like I said to you guys before, that every answer that comes from the Lord, if you have been praying for it, it's still a good answer. Sometimes, for example, you could be praying for a job and saying, oh, I want this job, Lord. And sometimes you think you're feeling it in the spirit, this is it. But then God just decided to say, no, my child, I've got something better for you. And then if you were still praying and praying and praying and praying and praying, even when those kind of answers come, sometimes you would at least say, but I prayed and it is okay, because I've been working with God and I've been praying about this. And He'll make you understand why He would have refused that. Many instances I've seen that in my life, that today I look back and I'm like, wow, thank you, Lord, you didn't give that to me. Thank you, Lord, you didn't give me that job that I wanted. Thank you, Jehovah. You know, there are certain places that you would have probably wanted a job at, and then those places today are closed down. Imagine. And at that time, the job seemed very lucrative. You're like, wow. There's obviously, when you're looking at something and an advert that is telling you it's going to pay you six figures, you think it's a wow, and God wants that for you. So that's why you need to pray. You need to pray so that the enemy doesn't get a chance to come into your life and deceive you, to making you think that this is a blessing, while in fact it's just, you know, in no way, no end, you know, just a misery or a curse. So pray, 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 pray without ceasing, guys. Prayer works. And then as I'm moving on to the next one, okay, and then the next one, which is the last one, will be wait on the Lord. Psalms 27 verse 14 says, wait on the Lord and be of good courage, and He shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Guys, after you have done all of these things, after you have confessed your sins and started a walk with Christ, after you have read your word, meditated on it every day, with all the time, in fellowship with Christ, be led by the Holy Spirit. After your way of life, guys, has been influenced by the Holy Spirit, picking yourself up where you fall and saying, yes, my Lord, no matter what, I'm human, but I know you're perfecting me for your grace and for your kingdom. And after you have stayed in prayer, after you have prayed and prayed, and remember, all of these things that I've said have to be influenced by the Holy Spirit. I can't give you a formula and say, this is how you have to pray. Yes, I can highlight to you, you know, like, this has worked for me. But God has a way of prayer for everyone. He has a way of prayer that works for, you know, like, for everyone. You know, maybe you might find that there's a category that uses this kind of prayer and it works for them. But at the end of the day, it's like, all of these things, the confession, the word, the way of life, the prayer, and waiting in peace have to be influenced by the help of the Holy Spirit. Not by the help of GATSM or not by the help of Pastor So-and-so. If it's Pastor So-and-so and it's working for you, I'm not saying that you should go and stop it with all due respect. But then at the end of the day, know that God can help you do these things. He can help you do these things through His Holy Spirit. Yes, He can send human agents and angels sometimes. That is still fairly okay, but you should be able also to discern that indeed this person has been sent by God to come and help me. After you have done all these things, guys, wait on the Lord. He says that you should wait on Him and wait in peace. As you're waiting on the Lord, He will answer. His answer shall surely come. It may seem like sometimes it's going to take for a while, but indeed it will surely come. Wait on the Lord because He is faithful. Guys, I thank you so much for watching this message. I thank you so much for being a part of this family. And I'd like to just say thank you very much for all the support that you have been giving me. And I just pray that the Lord may touch you in a different and a special way with this message. Guys, this is the gospel of Christ, and the gospel of Christ works. Do not lose heart. Hold on tight. Go ahead. Take whatever I've been teaching you. Go before the Lord and say, God, she says this. Is this your way of me to do my life or to walk my life? If it's not, and say, God, then teach me how to pray. Teach me how to confess my sins. Teach me how to wait on you, guys. That was just a brief for me of what I sometimes use. And you know what? My God is great, and I believe He is. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you, guys. May you be blessed and beyond. In Jesus' mighty name, thank you so much, and see you next time. Bye-bye.